Okay, we're getting in breaking news on Justice C.S. Karnan. He went through a medical checkup. A team of four doctors had arrived at Justice Karnan's residence, and they were escorted by the state police because Justice Karnan has called those orders from the Supreme Court ridiculous. Supreme Court had ordered a medical test on the Calcutta High Court judge who faces contempt charges. In fact, the rebel judge had imposed a no-fly bar on Chief Justice of India as well and the other Supreme Court judges. These are the visuals that we are getting right now on our screens. Let me go straight across now to Indrajit Kundu for more details and updates. Indrajit, did Justice C.S. Karnan cooperate with the team of medical doctors who were there to examine him?
Well, Avantika, at this point in time, what we're seeing right now is that Justice Karnan is, instructing his secretary to write a letter. He's dictating the letter to his secretary to be handed over to the person in charge of the medical team. There is a four-member medical team that have been formed by the State Health Department and who are here to execute the order, escorted by the Bidhannagar police. Now, as soon as they entered Justice Karnan's residence, Justice Karnan did come out downstairs and greeted them and met them and said that he was absolutely physically and mentally in sound health condition, and therefore he does not require any mental test at all. So he's at this point in time meeting the team. They are speaking to them, and what he has done is he has declined to take the medical examination that had been ordered by the Supreme Court. Rather, in his response to the head of the medical team, he is giving a written response right now, which is being typed even as we speak, and he has made very important points. He has termed this as a harassment of a Dalit judge.
Yes.
And he said that the Supreme Court order is an insult and a harassment of a Dalit judge. And he has also requested all the seven judges, including the Chief Justice of India,
yes,
to resign from their respective posts. So, in a sense, the antagonistic position that Justice Karnan had taken, remember just 2 days back, he had given a subsequent order, retaliatory order, many would say, of a medical examination, a mental examination of the seven judges of the Supreme Court after the Supreme Court gave an order of his medical test. So after the retaliatory order, now Justice Karnan has declined to accept the test. So it would be interesting to see as to how the procedure goes forward, because in any case, the DG of West Bengal has to execute this order. So they have done that principally. However, Justice Karnan has refused that medical test. So they'll have to get back to the Supreme Court.
And this is such a bizarre case, isn't it? He wants a medical examination on the seven-judge special bench of the Supreme Court, claiming that he is being framed by them. His denial and defiance would really not go down too well with the apex court, wouldn't it?
Well, absolutely. You know, as far as the legal point of view is concerned, Avantika, this is an unprecedented situation. In any case, this is a sitting judge,
yes,
remember, of the Calcutta High Court. He is facing contempt of court, proceedings before the Supreme Court. And he has also been barred from, going to his office at the Calcutta High Court. So, therefore, for the past few days, few weeks, in a sense, the various orders that Justice Karnan has delivered, he's delivered from his own residence by convening the court at his own residence. That is point number one. Point number two is that the Supreme Court in retrospect has also come out with an order stating that none of the courts in the country can actually execute the orders or the directives that Justice Karnan is issuing, because at this point, he is undergoing contempt proceedings. So Justice Karnan still continues to remain defiant. It would be worth noticing that in June he retires. So therefore, the Supreme Court might just go slow as well over this entire issue. But at this point, many would say in legal, in the legal fraternity, that Justice Karnan is almost acting like a loose cannon.
And he's not giving up just as yet. I mean, he's really taken on his fight against the Supreme Court and the seven-judge panel solely upon himself. He's already been stripped off of his judicial and administrative powers, but he continues to remain defiant and adamant.
Absolutely, absolutely. He continues to remain defiant. He's defiant. In fact, in the run-up to this this execution of this Supreme Court order just a short while back in the morning. In fact, he met the media and he was, you know, chatting with us, and he categorically stated that, you know, there is no sign of him relenting at this point in time. So he's not elaborating as to what is going to be his future course of action. Mm. But what Justice Karnan is telling us is that he has leveled grave allegations of corruption against 20 judges. And he's saying that given the fact that the suo-moto contempt proceedings has been initiated against him by a 7-judge bench of the Supreme Court, he is alleging that these 7 judges are in a sense siding with those corrupt. And therefore, it's a unilateral, you know, call that Justice Karnan had at this point taken. We'll have to wait and see as to how the Supreme Court, you know, responds to the developments that have taken place in Kolkata today.
Indrajit, you know, this is really a very bizarre case that the Supreme Court has been facing. As you rightly said, this is a sitting High Court judge which has taken on this apex court, violating every order. But he says that his main aim is to check corruption. He wants a probe against those 20 corrupt judges who he claims are corrupt to curb, you know, the kind of corruption that exists in Indian judiciary. Here is a person who stands very firm on his belief, but something that has also not gone down well with the Supreme Court.
Whatever we have seen unfolding at this point in time in Kolkata, this is unprecedented.
Yes.
There is no precedent as far as the legal proceedings in India is concerned. So it's difficult for us to even speculate as to what can happen from now on. But the fact of the matter remains that Justice Karnan, you know, being in his inimitable style, has leveled very serious allegations. Mm-hmm. And the letters that he had written it to the Law Ministry, to the Prime Minister's office and other departments as well, calling for an investigation. Now, there are quarters within the judiciary who are also saying, and there are activists also who are saying, that there is need for some amount of introspection as far as the Indian judiciary is concerned, because it is not something that most people are not unaware of, that there is some amount of corruption. Now, whether that introspection happens after this, whether the Supreme Court takes into cognizance, or, you know, comes down heavily on Justice Karnan, given his retaliatory attitude, is what we'll have to see.
Right, Indruji, thank you so much for joining us and really giving us all the updates and details. So Justice C.S. Karnan there refusing to get a medical examination and telling the medical team who were escorted by the police that he's absolutely fine.